Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, guys. Josh here, back with another video, another clandestine video. We're shooting in places we're not supposed to be, security's everywhere, and we're probably gonna get kicked out. Now, before I get kicked out of here, I am at Asharia. Now, you might be like, who cares and what is that? Right behind me is a building that is so critical to my marriage, man. And that is what today's video is all about. I'm taking you all over Tennessee. I'm taking you to four different towns, four different critical places. And with each place, I'm gonna answer one of the reoccurring questions that I get all the time. Not for myself, we get questions all the time about marriage. So inshallah, I'm gonna share with you the answers based upon the critical places that, you know, really helped our marriage flourish, inshallah. Now the reason, guys, why I brought you to this specific location is because this is where I accepted Islam. In this very building right here, this is where I met that Muslim sister 8 years ago that led me to accepting Islam. Now, you might be asking yourself, okay, what does that have to do with your current relationship? Well, it's pretty clear, guys. It has everything to do with, that was a haram relationship, man. I should never have been in that relationship. Of course, I wasn't Muslim, but this leads to the question that we get all the time, or the statement, you know, the concerns that, dude, I'm in a haram relationship with somebody, what do I do? Now, my advice to you is make tawbah to Allah and do one of two things. Bounce, split, or make it halal as soon as possible, guys. As soon as possible, guys, because, dude, from my experience, as soon as I accepted Islam, shortly thereafter, that marriage, that relationship went down south real quick, man. Further down south than we are here in Tennessee. Dad jokes, there you go. But man, here comes the security, guys. So that's the point, man, is, dude, if you're in a haram relationship, man, you gotta get out of it as soon as possible, or you have to make it halal as soon as possible. That being said, I'm probably about to get kicked out. We'll see you in the next scene. So we totally got kicked out of that place. Yep, that security guard flew up right on me, man. Was like, can I help you? I was like, snap, peace out, gotta go again. I'm the law, man. I do it for the, you know what I'm saying? I do it for the entertainment, pleasure, the aspects, and you know, just to deliver awesome content to you guys. Now, if we get kicked out of the masjid by the Muslims, man, we got a problem. Now, guys, the reason why I brought you to the Islamic Center of Tennessee is because, first and foremost, man, I'm gonna apologize because this video is gonna be all over the place. This is not in sequential order. This isn't how, you know, you go about things. This should always be number one, but this is how the video is rolling. Bismillah. But you should always seek help with Allah. And after you seek help with Allah, guys, you have to seek help from your communities, man. You know, to be honest with you guys, I've never shared this with you, but I believe if my memory serves me correctly, 6 years ago, man, I was $4,000 behind in my child support. Dude, $4,000 behind. In fact, because I simply couldn't afford it, I was making minimum wage, man, and living with my mom at the time, dude, as a Muslim, man. I was living with my mom as a Muslim in my first, after the whole relationship didn't work between me and that sister, the homelessness thing, eventually I was with my mom, right? But the point is that I had no money to actually pay child support, and I wound up going to jail, man. And in order to get my passport unlocked, or you know, they locked my passport, or they froze my passport, I had to pay like $4,000 in child support, dude. And it was only because after Allah, the just generous community, man, they came together during Ramadan and, you know, all this funding, man, they allowed me to be able to pay off that debt, get my passport unfrozen, so that I could go travel to my wife, man. So you have got to, you know what I'm saying, seek help in Allah, and then seek help from your community to actually help you get married, man. Now, quick disclaimer, guys, I am not advocating or advising you to get married to someone who is in a crazy amount of debt. That is up to you to decide if that is a deal breaker for you. That was something that, again, I brought to Nasra's attention. I said, hey, this is what my issue is. I can't come travel to you right now. I gotta pay off this debt, etc., etc. And you know, that was something that alhamdulillah she was willing to accept, guys. So that goes back to the fact, you know, to the point that we're constantly repeating and hammering in your heads over and over and over again. You got to decide what your non-negotiables are, and then you got to start making connections with people, like we mentioned previously, man. Firstly, with Allah, connect with Allah, deep connection with Allah is that with gel. then start making connections, man, and showing that you're serious about getting married, and start taking action, man. Assalamu alaikum, guys. Here we are at another location that I cannot disclose specific details because we want to respect the homeowner's privacy, man. But the reason why I brought you here is because right up there, guys, that is exactly where I met Nasra 6 years ago, alhamdulillah. Now, the reason why I brought you to this specific location is very simple, man. We get the question all the time, should I be concerned that I'm only able to offer a little bit to my spouse? And so my advice to you guys is build from the basics, man. When I first met Nasra, man, this is what I had to offer her, you know? It's a simple, basic, one-bedroom apartment, right? We had a bathroom, we had a kitchen, had no cupboards, right? Had a living room, and we had a bedroom, right? It was simple, and it wasn't a whole lot to offer her. But at the same time, we were always, you know, considering the mindset of we're trying to take our lives to the next level all the time, right? So we're just starting from the fundamentals, man, from the basics, right? But we're gonna build upon that. And this is not gonna be our final resting place, bidni Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is not gonna be our final home. This is just where we have to begin our origin story, right? So the point is, guys, is don't overly stress, you know, the little that you may have to offer your spouse, because a lot of us guys, you might be 18, 19, 20, maybe just graduated college. You're not gonna have a lot to offer your spouse. Now, if your parents, if they're wealthy, if they have money and they, you know, they help you out, that's one thing. But a lot of us guys, we don't have wealthy parents. And so it's pretty common knowledge that, hey, I don't have a lot to offer you, but I have a lot of potential. I have a lot of ambition. These are my goals. These are my dreams. This is what I'm going after. And you know what I'm saying? You share the dream with them, you sell them on the dream, and inshallah, things will be great. What's up, guys? Here we are at another location where we're probably not supposed to be filming at. Probably gonna get kicked out pretty quickly because we like to live on the edge, bro. Now, where we're at right now is American Home Patient, right? Or we call it A Home for short. Now, the reason why I brought you to this specific location is because this is the first job that I got when I first got married to Nasra. Man, I thought I was avoiding the airplanes, but not today. Anyways, guys, when I first married Nasra, I didn't even have a job. I had a job lined up. I was supposed to start this job in the next week or so. But the reason why I'm bringing this to your attention, guys, is because, it's because we get the question of, hey, I'm interested in this guy, but he doesn't have a job. What do you advise me to do? And the thing is, you know, there's a couple different answers, man. If this dude doesn't have a job, he doesn't want to get a job, you know, there are brothers that literally want, unfortunately, wala hawla wala quwwata illa billah, they want the wife to handle the responsibilities, man, and they'd be a stay-at-home dad. Or they want 50-50. And I'm like, subhanAllah, guys, if you agree to that, all right, alhamdulillah. But that is not what Allah and His Messenger have legislated, man. So if that dude doesn't want to work, that's one option. If he just lost his job, but he has some savings and he's looking for another job, that's another option, right? If, you know, he's got something lined up, again, you have to be the one to make that final call and that final decision of what you're comfortable with. But I'm just sharing with you guys what we personally went through, right? I had a job lined up. Her parents didn't even know that I didn't have a job. Again, I had one lined up, already took the drug test. It was just like, you guys, you know, you start next week. So that's just another piece of advice, man. Another thing, you know, that we get asked all the time, man, is should I marry somebody who doesn't have a job? And hopefully that clarifies the answer. What's up, guys? Put 20 minutes on the clock, because after 20 minutes, your boy is gonna get charged for parking. Now, where I brought you today is the International Airport of Nashville, or commonly referred to as BNA. Now, the reason why I brought you to this specific location is because this signifies commitment, man. And what I refer to that, what I mean by that is, dude, I literally had to travel 8,000 plus miles, or approximately 13,000 kilometers, over three different countries in order to legitimize my relationship and my marriage with my wife Nasra in the eyes of the US government. Now, guys, before we get any further into this video, if you're getting value from the channel and you want to help support the channel and you want to invest in your own self, then I personally suggest that you join MTG Nation, bro. MTG Nation is our go-to amazing Muslim community of people, man, who are actually serious about achieving their dreams. Now, what you can expect to get within the private membership of MTG Nation, man, is 8 to 10 hours approximately of content every single month, breaking down how I am able to be a full-time employee, yet and still never miss a workout, run and grow a full-time YouTube channel, have an amazing relationship with my wife, amazing relationship with my kids, and so much more. I'm gonna give you early access to the videos that I drop Mondays and Thursdays. I'm gonna give you early access to merch. I'm gonna give you discounts on merch. I'm gonna give you so much value, guys, and guess what? It only costs $5 a month. It's so easy, man. It's so simple. I've removed all excuses as to why you can't afford it. I made it affordable for everybody, man, because I want you to change your life. So if you wanna join MTG Nation, bro, hit that first link down in the description below. It's gonna take you straight to where you need to go. $5 a month. And with that being said, let's get back in the video. We losing daylight, bro. It's getting cold out here. I'm gonna have to pray Maghrib, and we got one more location to go. Now again, man, this is all about commitment, man. Marriage is not easy, guys. It takes commitment every single day, all right? So this is just a reminder, guys, that whenever you do anything in life, commit fully, man. If that means that you have to travel across multiple countries, thousands of miles, across the ocean, to be with the one that you want to be with, then that's what you need to do, bro. All right, guys, let's see if we made the 20-minute mark, or if your boy is fitting to pay for this YouTube video.
Please enter your ticket with the arrow up and pointed towards the machine.
Yes, sir. Am I good? Am I good? Card not permitted or eligible. What are you talking about? What? I think I, duh. We good, man. We ain't paying for jack squat. Let's roll. SubhanAllah. What is up, guys? Here we are at the U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services building. Now, I gotta keep this quick, man, and brief because a number of reasons. Firstly, I got mugged up in like 10 minutes. Secondly, there's dog turds right there. Thirdly, there's prostitutes and drug dealers all over this joint. So, let's get to the point, shall we? Now, guys, the reason why I brought you here again, this is so critical to Nasra and my relationship, man. You know, we had to go through literally 6 years of not knowing, uncertainty, if we can be together and remain together, guys. And that is because she had to get her citizenship, man. And at any point, they could have denied her and sent her back to Kenya, man. So this is basically about, you know, for those who, hey, should we seek someone elsewhere, right? This is encouragement for one. Dude, if you can't find someone in your location, like we always say, look elsewhere. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean you have to look, you know, in another country. Look in your general location, maybe within your state or the next state over, or even, you know, somewhere within your country, man. Like for us, the 50 states of America, I'm in Tennessee, I could find someone in New York, or I could find someone in California. And even though that might be like a day's drive or something like that, or a few hours flight, that's still within the country. You don't have to go through all the immigration process. But for those of you who can't, for whatever reason, Allah hasn't decreed it, you have this opportunity. Now, at the same time, for those of you who have found a spouse or do find a spouse within your location or within your general location of a country, you can be thankful, man, and grateful that you didn't have to go through the same struggles that we did. I'm really just making sure I didn't step in dog poop because Masjid Salam is over there. I've never taken any Masjid Salam before. Well, I have, but I don't think I told you it was Masjid Salam. And I'm not trying to track in dog poop into the Masjid, bro. So hopefully the point is clear. It's cold out here. I gotta go pray Maghrib. I'm gonna get some amazing Asr Somali tea, inshallah. And we're gonna end this video at Masjid Salam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi, guys. Here we are at Masjid Salam. Unfortunately, your boy could not score some of that amazing Asr tea, and that's because the place was closed, man. SubhanAllah, dude. Shut down for business, man. Ah, that sucks. But alhamdulillah, mashallah, you know, qadarullah mashafa, it is what it is, man. But man, that's the video. I hope that you guys got value from today's video, we hit like, dude, four different towns in a matter of like a couple hours, man. I started recording around 2:30 and we finished at 4:30, man. So alhamdulillah, we cranked out a ton of miles and getting kicked out of places and dropping knowledge. Alhamdulillah, I hope that you got value from today's video, guys. If you did, you know what to do, man. Drop your boy like down below because it truly does help the channel. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe and hit that notifications bell because I'm dropping two new videos every single week, every Monday and every Thursday, plus two live streams every single week on all things mindset, marriage, and the Muslim struggle, man. So if you're picking up what I'm putting down, dude, subscribe and become a part of this amazing community that Allah has allowed me to build, alhamdulillah. That being said, guys, Jazakallah khairan, barakallahu feekum. As always, stop worrying about yesterday, stop worrying about tomorrow, make today great. One last thing I just remembered, if there's any other questions, comments, concerns that you have about marriage and you want us to do a part two with Nasra, my wife Nasra, then drop those comments and those questions, those concerns in the comments below, bro. And inshallah, we're gonna do a part two if that's what you guys want, all right? Stop worrying about yesterday, stop worrying about tomorrow, make today great. And I will see you in that next one. Today, we are actually at the Vanderbilt Psychiatric Hospital, man. I know this is kind of weird, but I feel this is contextually relevant for today's video, man. I have to make sure that I can get this video done before they kick me out of here, because they said only staff and only...